First couple of days are over, and I'm getting settled in London. Now it's time to get in contact with my subjects. How to get in contact with them? I've found a list of venues that are going to be used in preparation of the 2012 Olympics. So I will go and contact them via phone and email, but also just visit them and see if the place is suitable to do research. So that's my first step. So I've been to a couple of venues and not much success so far. Either they were not very much used or even open at all. For example, the Linford Christie Stadium was only used by some rugby guys. Well, behind me you can see the Newham Leisure Centre, and that's a bit of a different story. I just went inside and they it was largely used, as you can see. A lot of people here. And the resident club here is the club of Christine O'Hoogan, the only gold medalist of the UK last summer in Beijing.
That's Christine O'Hoogan. There's a medal up for grabs, and Williams is coming through for Jamaica. Williams is coming through. Sonia Richards is tying up, and Christine O'Hoogan. Christine O'Hoogan takes the gold medal. The world champion becomes the Olympic champion.
January 2009 was London's coldest month in 20 years. My list of venues was therefore useless, as almost all outdoor facilities were deserted. Behind me you see the Crystal Palace Arena, the athletic stadium. In search of my respondents, I had to look for indoor venues. And after a difficult 3 weeks in London, I finally found the best centre possible.
Okay, my name's Brian Hopkins. I'm one of the managers at the Lee Valley Athletic Centre, which is where a lot of our top athletes in the country come and train. We are very proud insofar as the athletes that represented Great Britain at the last Olympic Games in Beijing. Lee Valley Athletic Centre provided a third of the team that went to Beijing. And of the four medals that were earned by Great Britain, three of those came from athletes that train here.
Brian Hopkins of the Lee Valley Athletic Centre was a great help. He made me feel welcome at the centre and introduced me to several interesting athletes. Even though I now found a good place, my search also continued, since the intention of my research was to look also into the ambition of younger athletes, with the dream to compete at the Olympics in 2012. I eventually found these athletes at the community-based sports center of Willesden, which was led by a couple of former athletes. The head coach was Connie Henry.
My name's Connie Henry. I'm an ex-track and field athlete. I work primarily in sports broadcasting now, but what I do also is run a track and field squad here in London, North West London, Willesden. It's from 11 years to basically whenever. You can be as old as you like, but 11 is probably the youngest we like to take. And it's been running for a couple of years, and in that short space of time, we've been very successful.
So I took my first hurdle. I now had two centers to conduct research, and at these two centers, my respondents varied from the youngest, the stars of the moment, to the former international athletes who now coach the upcoming generation.
I've got summer to come. You've got to get angry, you're going to get aggressive, whatever it takes. Tell yourself a positive story right now. 10 seconds. Come on, it's in the mind. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
So, another day at the Lee Valley Center. I had some good talks, but also some long time of just watching and sitting around. I guess that's just part of doing field research. The next step was the actual research, and I found my places to conduct it. But though being important, observing was not the only way to collect my data. I really wanted to talk to them as well. My first interview was with Connie, who then introduced me to a large number of her athletes. Like for instance Andre Fernandez, who combined his personal training with coaching of the younger athletes at Willesden Center.
So we started off where we had no official athletes, yeah. And what we've done is we've turned school kids into athletes.
Okay.
So.
Yeah, great. But you're an athlete yourself as well.
That's right, yeah.
Okay. Uh-huh. And what are your aims?
My aims, I just want to get as far as I possibly can. I mean, whether it's, you know, Olympics, world record holder, you know, even if it's just to be national champion, which I've achieved.
Okay.
That's it.
At the Willesden Club, I've interviewed almost every coach and promising athlete. I felt very welcome at this club, which helped also with the participant observation. In the 3 months of my research, I became part of this squad by helping the coaches and cheering for the athletes at the matches. At the Lee Valley Center, participant observation was a lot harder. Here the top athletes were training more individual, so there was not much of a group to become a part of. The help of Brian Hopkins compensated this, as he introduced me to top athletes training at this venue. One of them was James Alaka, who got injured just before our interview, but still took the time to talk to me.
Okay, Sheffield is the next big match?
Yeah, Sheffield is my next competition. Well, I'm not even sure if I'm going to be doing Sheffield now, because okay. I kind of hurt my hamstring doing that last 6 days.
It's a serious
thing. Well, we're not too sure yet.
Okay.
It's hurt quite a bit, but when we get it assessed, see.
Yeah, are you ever afraid of getting injured? Is it always in your mind?
I mean, I've been injured so many times that it doesn't really affect me. Normally, when I get injured, coming back from injury, I perform better than I did before I got injured. Okay. So,
talking to the athletes was hard in the beginning, but after I was introduced, it began to roll. I became more confident, and as a result, I spoke to many well-known track and field athletes. Just by daring to approach them with my story. Almost all of them were interested and willing to talk to me. Even Dwayne Chambers, a sprinter with a history in performance-enhanced drugs.
Well, that decision was based on me being inexperienced, being impatient, not really being the individual that wanted to wait for the results to come. You know, so used to being successful and winning and winning and winning.
So the summary after 2 months, I'm in a bit rainy Hyde Park, but behind me you can see that the spring is already coming. I had a good 2 months, I think, but this is really the moment to reflect. The subjects really are the ones I'm looking for, but well, this is the moment, as I said, to type out some interviews, because I'm not really sure if I'm asking the right questions.
With this last problem, my supervisor of the FU helped me out. Every 2 weeks I send him a report with my developments and struggles, on which he responded by giving me the focus I needed. It's very easy to get lost in a subject while doing fieldwork. For me, these moments of reflecting prevented that from happening.
So, back to home, back to typing out the interviews.